Hey peeps, welcome back to my channel. In this video, as the title says, we're going to scrape Instagram, meaning we're not using their API. We are using their normal website to get information from it, to use it to our advantage or whatever we want to do with that. And we're going to code that from scratch using pure Swift code, no third-party libraries. And don't be worried if it's just Swift code and you're not a Swift coder, but this is actually also a good inspiration for you to like implement it in JavaScript, in Kotlin, in C Sharp, in Java, whatever languages suits your needs or whatever language you love the most. And I love Swift, so that's why we are here to do that in Swift. I will code that from scratch using Playground. You can even code along, just fire up Playground and watch that video. And again, we are not using any third-party libraries. Why don't we just like open Xcode and dive right into it? Opening Xcode in a wrong screen, on the wrong screen, creating a new playground in the wrong screen again, calling it in the wrong screen. I just came up with that. How spontaneous is that? The cool thing is I already have the right line font size here. So first thing, we are going to define the Instagram base URL, because I mean, we have to request at least Instagram. That's the plan, right? Instagranny and a trailing slash, because the next thing is we will define a username, and that can be any username you want. Try my username. If you don't follow me on Instagram yet, try and check if you can follow me. I promise it will work. Let's use Jake Gyllenhaal. No, I didn't press Gyllenhaal. God damn it. I pronounced it somewhat right and then I pronounced it wrong. I think he mentioned that he's from somewhere where it's actually called Gyllenhaal or Gyllenhaal, whatever. I'm not sure whether he trolls the world or me or whether that is the right pronunciation of his last name. However, at this course, he's my favorite actor. He's actually the only actor I know. By the definition of actor, how I think actors should be when they are actors. Am I saying too many times actors? Let's define a URL out of these both strings. URL, no auto-completion for the class URL because we haven't imported foundation. So once again, URL is equal to URL. There we go. We will initiate with string and we are going to build that string out of our Instagram base URL and the username. Now you know why we need that backslash here, forward slash. So if we run that with shift enter on the right side, we will see the right URL composed the way we want it. And if we fire that up in the browser, we are going to get the profile of Jake Gyllenhaal. And he's having 1.4 million followers. That's pretty amazing. Considering he just recently created Instagram, which I'm a big fan of Instagram and of him creating an account, the 5th of December, like not even 2 months ago. That's awesome. How did he get his name? I bet there was an account before called like that. Now that poor guy actually it wasn't his right to have it. Anyway, this course again. So, okay, how do we actually fire a request to receive that website? In Swift, for some reason, everyone is calling it task, like the variable is called task. You can call it whatever, right? It's a variable. So whatever, no, task. And we are using URL session in order to fire requests. And we're not initiating it ourselves. We are using shared that will return an instance of URL session. I'm just using that because that's best practice, so to say. We're just using URL session once here, but in our like daily life coding, we most likely use URL session multiple times, and we want to make sure we are using the same instance, so singleton, so we don't have any troubles with that. However, we are going to pass in URL, and what we are going to receive back is either data, response, or error. It's not rezo, it's response, told you. And I said or, which means they are all optionals. We have to unwrap them. Basically, or actually, we are only using data here. We only need data. We know that if that succeeds, if we get a response from that URL, which we will, we just checked, it works, it will be inside data. So let's just use data here. We will unwrap data, and if that didn't work out, sorry for my pronunciation, English is a very hard language, I heard. Data was nil, in case it was nil. Makes sense? Early return here. So I always forget for some reason guard let, the let statement. I mean, I say guard let and then just write guard. I have no idea why. So did I miss anything else here that we don't have a... I think that works. So we have data now for sure, it's not nil. We know it's a website, we know it's HTML. So why don't we just cast it into a string and print it to see what it looks like. So let's call it guard let. Don't forget the let, please. I'm telling it myself. I mean, you sure don't forget that. And let's cast data into string using not that, please. UTF-8 encoding. If that didn't work out, please tell us that didn't work out. Cannot cast data into string. Early return here. So let's print HTML string and let's have a look at what it actually is. Resume is the function to execute the URL session request, so to say. So shift enter will actually, oh, URL is having problems. Yeah, because that's an optional. URL is an optional if we pass in a string, since the string that we're passing in must be a proper URL. And if it's not, the instance will actually, or actually will from the initiator get nil returned. That's why it's optional. We will just force unwrap because we know, don't hate on me. Stop it. We know that this is a proper URL. Oh, what I mean by proper URL, it should not have special characters in it. I think a special character would be that. I think that wouldn't work. We could try it out, but that's not the video. So shift enter down here, and we are going to have the whole website in our console. You see here, it's HTML. And I know, because I investigated, I inspected it before, that we have a huge head. Yeah, link is always an indication we are still in the head, and at some point it must end, so it's right here, and the body starts. Inside body, we have a huge JavaScript object right here. And luckily, inside that JavaScript object, all information is stored that is used by Instagram to display the data on the website, like image, follower count, how many posts, the post itself, the comments, whatsoever. All of it is inside here. Well, actually, I must say, I'm not sure about the comments, but that's not important. The profile information is important. And so there is somewhere a key called followed by, and it will have a count and tell us how many follower Jake Gyllenhaal has. And we have it right here, edge followed by count, and it is 1.4 million. Whoa, who would have guessed? So we are looking for, I'm doing a lot of, I have to stop that. Sorry for that, I'll just focus right now. We are going to, we are trying to get that value. How are we going to achieve that? Now, to the left side of that value, we have this whole string, right? And actually up until this one, like edge followed by is a pretty unique string, so to say. Edge followed by is a key inside a, like inside object, JavaScript object, you have a key value notation, and that's a key, and it's pretty unique. We can use that whole string on the very like the first thing left to the value that we are looking for. We have this kind of string that is very unique in this order, let's say. So let's just store it in left side of the value. Let's call it the value. And with the value, I mean the value that we are looking for. So this is the left side of the value, right? That's the very left side. And we have on the right side the same thing. We have also again a key. So that kind of string that we are like copying right now is kind of unique inside this whole HTML string as well, which means if we are looking for that string that we are just about to save here in a variable, that will be, that will result most likely just in one result. That will result into a result. What I mean by that is, if we look for that string, it will only have one result because it just exists once in that whole HTML string, which is good for us. So right side of the value is equal to the actual right side of the value. Now, we are going to use now is the function range that is provided for strings to get the range where that left side of the value and right side of the value is located inside the whole HTML string. What that allows us is, if we know the range, like let's say we are looking up that string inside HTML, let's just do that. Left range is equal to HTML string, right? Inside here, we are looking for the range of the left side value of the value, like that. If that didn't work, please let us know. Cannot find left range. Now, that left range will actually describe where that string is located inside HTML string. It will have an upper and a lower bound. We are going to use that in a second, I'll explain. So let's just do that for the right side as well. Gord right range is equal to HTML string range of, perfect, right side value of the value. Please pronounce the variables you just created correctly. Oh, I forgot the early return up here. You probably have done it. I missed it. Print, like cannot find right range early return. Now we are now at this point where we know left range and right range is given at line 83. If it's not given, it will either print and return or again arrive at line 38. And we know that, for example, the range of that string, the upper bound, which is the colon right here, is actually the lower bound of the value, because from these both ranges we can use the upper bound and the lower bound to describe a new range that is actually describing the very position of the value we are looking for. Isn't that convenient? Is that expensive in calculation? I have no idea, but let's just do it. So we are creating range of the value is equal to, okay, what did we say? Left range, upper bound, left range, upper, do we have auto-completion? No. Did I do something wrong? Yes. Why didn't you mention, I've forgotten the let again. Again, I just mentioned that in the beginning, I'm always forgetting them. Anyway, so left range, upper bound we said, and here comes the range operator, and right range, lower bound, that gives us the value in that HTML string. What we can do with that is simply, like you would have done with an index, subscript from that HTML string and providing that range of the value of the value. And let's just print that right away and see whether I did any error. And I didn't. We have 1.4 million follower for Jake Gyllenhaal here. Console log, not console log, but printed in our console. I say console log because I also write JavaScript. God damn it, that's not this video. So it worked, right? So we have that follower count. You can do the same thing for image URL. You can do the same thing for anything else that is inside that JavaScript object. And so you can now, for example, let's say we now take my profile and just fire at that. It works. Because now you see, he had like 1.4 millions. How many characters was that? 7. I have 15,000. That is just 5 characters. Which means, like, as I said, the value that we are looking for was that is that little for me, like 5 characters in that string. For Jake Gyllenhaal, it's 7, it's bigger. That's dynamic, it changes. However, the left side of these of that value never changed, actually never changed as long as Instagram is not changing their website, which could be happen, but this is not happen, will not happen right now and will not probably happen in the next weeks or months, I hope. Anyway, so the left side is not changing, it's not dynamic, it's a key, it's a string, and the right side as well. So no matter what is the value, like it's small because of only of 10 followers, it's big because of 100 trillion follower, it doesn't matter, because if we look for these ranges and we use their upper and lower bound to create that new range, we will always find the value. And there you go. If you like that video, if it's something you want to see more of, hit that like button, let me know in the comments. And yeah, see you over in Instagram. There, my profile link is in the description, you can just follow that. And see you also in the next video.